When talking about iconic 2000s musical acts, Ciara absolutely has to be in that conversation. While she wasn't the biggest star of the decade, she was undoubtedly an A-lister who had numerous hits that are still well known to this day. Her first two albums saw massive success, with singles like Goodies and Like a Boy becoming radio staples. Ciara's star was shining bright, but her momentum seemingly stalled out with 2009's Fantasy Ride. The album didn't achieve the same success as its predecessors, and while Ciara has remained a huge name in the music industry, she may have been even bigger had it not been for this album's disappointing performance. What went wrong with Fantasy Ride? Is it a bad album, or was it simply underappreciated? To get started, let's dive into some background for the album. Fantasy Ride was originally meant to be a 3-disc album. The discs were going to be called Crunktown, Kingdom of Dance, and Groove City, with each having a different musical style that would reflect their names. While it's unclear if Fantasy Ride was going to be a super long album, it's safe to assume with 3 discs, there was probably a lot of songs made for it. The 3-disc idea was eventually scrapped, but the 3 different styles are still present throughout the album. Examples include the planned lead single High Price featuring Ludacris, which was meant to be on Crunktown, Never Ever featuring Young Jeezy, which was meant to be on Groove City, and Love Sex Magic featuring Britney Spears' ex, which was meant to be on Kingdom of Dance. The triple disc idea was a clever way of integrating her older crunk and R&B sound along some synthy electropop cuts. Remember, Ciara debuted in 2004, when hip-hop and R&B was the dominant genre. By 2008, electronic and dance pop had exploded in popularity, and artists had to change their sounds up to stay current. However, given Ciara's history of dance songs, it didn't seem too far off for her to make an album that would fit in with the music of the time. Her second album was especially filled with 80s-inspired dance tracks, so this wasn't unfamiliar territory for her. With how well she had been doing commercially, it seems like Fantasy Ride was poised to be another huge era. Ciara began the promo cycle with one of the coolest publicity stunts I've ever heard of. For one day in September 2008, she went to Six Flags Over Georgia, where the roller coaster Goliath was renamed Fantasy Ride. She also did a meet and greet with fans and signed autographs. Did anyone go to this? I'm genuinely curious. This is awesome. Anyways, after getting off the non-Fantasy Ride, the single started to roll out. The album's lead single, Go Girl, featuring T-Pain, was released on September 26, 2008. The song underperformed, peaking at number 78 on the Hot 100 for 1 week before dropping off the charts entirely. Due to this poor performance, the song wasn't included on the standard edition of Fantasy Ride, though it was tacked on as a bonus track for the Japanese release. This is a damn shame because Go Girl is a bop. It is so 2008, and I mean that in the best way. Never Ever was the second single. It's a mid-tempo ballad as well as a mid-ballad. Okay, Never Ever is not among the best songs on Fantasy Ride. It's not even one of the better ballads on Fantasy Ride, so it clearly wasn't the best choice as a second single. It failed to chart on the Hot 100, and yeah, I could see why. It's not bad at all. It's just not great, and definitely not a good pick as the second single. At this point, it was becoming questionable if Fantasy Ride was gonna do well, as it lacked a hit single before its release, unlike her previous albums. Luckily, the third single, Love Sex Magic, fared much better. The song peaked at number 10 on the Hot 100, and apparently did well internationally as well. I remember hearing the song on the radio a lot, so it's definitely the highlight of this era. The song Like a Surgeon was planned to be a single, but for whatever reason, those plans were scrapped. Although, I swear to God, I remember hearing it on the radio as a kid. I'm definitely just misremembering that, but I don't know, I swear I heard it back in the day. I'm probably just thinking of a similar song though. The actual final single, Work featuring Missy Elliott, was released over a year later in 2009. Once again, the song didn't chart on the Hot 100 and failed to garner much attention, which again is a shame because it's a great song. Missy Elliott plus Ciara on the track always leads to a bop, and this is probably their most underrated one. But with that, the Fantasy Ride era came to an end. While it wasn't necessarily a flop, she'd be getting to that with her next album. It definitely started the downward commercial performance of her music. Fantasy Ride, for whatever reason, didn't connect with audiences. This may be due to the seemingly abrupt image change Ciara took on for this era. Similar to what Beyoncé would do on I Am Sasha Fierce, Ciara took on a different persona for Fantasy Ride, becoming Super C. No, not the Super Nintendo game. While I can't speak for the general public of 2009, I could just say personally, I don't really think the superhero vibe comes across in the album itself. I love the artwork for the cover, which was actually done with DC Comics artist Bernard Chang, but I don't really get superhero from Fantasy Ride. Not that that's a bad thing, but I do think the marketing may have confused people. Ciara is the princess of Krunk, so for her to do a pivot into seemingly cartoony, bombastic electropop was probably jarring. The irony is, I actually don't think this album sounds too far removed from her last one. Ciara the Evolution was a pretty dance-heavy album with electronic and 80s-inspired production, and while I do think Fantasy Ride leans more into pop as opposed to R&B, the R&B is definitely still there. I personally love Fantasy Ride. I'd rank it up there with her self-titled album and her other self-titled album as my favorites by her. It really is a ride. It's just craziness throughout, from her opera-like vocals on High Price to the frantic production on Turntables. That's not even to mention the lyrics on some of these songs, which are hilarious in parts. Especially the song G is for Girl, A to Z. She literally goes through the whole alphabet, listing reasons why she's that girl. It's legit impressive how she was able to think of something for each letter. It's so over the top, I just love it. Pucker Up is another hilarious song, with her repeatedly telling you, you can kiss her swag. God, this really was 2008, wasn't it? I think this campiness may have gotten lost on audiences since they had already known Ciara as a primarily crunk and R&B artist who took herself a little more seriously than how she portrayed herself on Fantasy Ride. It's not like how Lady Gaga or Kesha came out immediately as eccentric pop personas. Ciara already had an image, and this album may have came across as her trying too hard to fit in. While Ciara's career eventually recovered, it never reached the heights of her first two albums, and it's hard to not see Fantasy Ride as the beginning of that decline. It makes you wonder what the trajectory of her career would have been had she gone in a different direction for this album, or if it had simply been marketed differently. Still, Ciara's doing perfectly well to this day, and while Fantasy Ride wasn't the huge success it should have been, it still has its fans. Maybe Super C will come back one day to record another record. Alright, probably not, but I can dream, can't I?